that a devil can do about it.
Oh, I'm blessed.
In the morning, in the noontime, dawn's on
the just to hear, you are giving a thing to your servant, fruitfulness. And it's our year of showers of blessing. And when you look at the book of Ezekiel 34, verse 26, it says there will be showers of blessing upon who? Upon his people. And anytime there is showers of blessing, and there must be fruitfulness. How many of you want to bear fruit this year? How many of you want to be fruitful in every area of your life? I know that your man of God is a man of prayer. And I have been praying for you from the beginning of this year. But I want to teach you this evening. Praise the Lord. When you receive the word of God in you, it can break every yoke in your life and pull every mountain on your way. We look at the book of Philippians 4, verse 13. And the word of God make it clear through Apostle Paul. He said, I can do all things through Christ that strengtheneth me. If you must be fruitful this year, and you want to see the showers of blessing, please listen to me. Look at me. I need your attention. Your stand with Christ matter. Paul did not say I can do all things because I'm a graduate. He did not say I can do all things because I can pray 3 hours a day. He said, but I can do all things through Christ that strengtheneth me. The number one question I must ask you today, who is your strength? Where do you stand? Where is your stand in God? I'm seeing today people are hurting for prayer. No one wants to see the face of God. No one is bothered to know him. One of the problems we have, we claim we love God. We are not willing to obey his commandments. Now, God's servant, God has spoken to him that is our year of showers of blessing. How many of you are key to that word? That this year, 2020, whether the devil like it or not, there must be showers of blessing. How many of you? He says something that he welcome every one of you. But how will you be doing the program in your church? You can't invite a soul. One, meaning you never believe in the program. Two, you never believe in the church. He came to our 12 days online. It's a covenant online for more than 12 years. And by God's grace, since the online started, I'll be inviting him. Praise the Lord. It was a mandate. How will somebody go to all nights every day for 12 nights? When we started on the first, that was the day we received here, the lower attendant was 130. From there, 300. 400, the last day was about 600 people online. Because the member and understand that is our vision, is our church, is a yearly covenant. Every night represents a month. By the time you finish that 12 night, we are already living in 2021. It's a covenant. And God also have a covenant with your son that every January 31 day fasting. Am I right? 32 days, have you? How many of you appeal to this vision? I want to understand the reason why many Christians are not being blessed. Some are operating under closed heaven, while few are operating under open heaven. I want to speak on a message entitled, "The Key That Opened Heaven Over Your Life." The keys that open heaven over your life. The keys. Prayer is good. Today you will not fall around on the floor. You need to receive the word of God. But the Bible said, He sent His word, and His word healed them and delivered them from all their infirmity and their iniquities. If you are serving God, the evidence of serving God is not in your life. You are making mockery of the kingdom of God. The word of God said, "Let your light shine." Where is the light? Let people see the hand of God in your life. They will say, "Oh, brother, I thank God for your life." For example, before you gave your life to Christ, you were once the type that sick. After giving your life to Christ, no more sickness. People will glorify God and say, "Oh, brother, I thank God for your life." Before you gave your life to Christ, no food to eat, but now you are the one feeding others. People will glorify God for your life. When we look at today, Christian, they are seeking for miracles. No one wants to know God on their own. That is why you see prophets springing up every corner. They want to tell you your father name you already are aware of. At the end of the day, you are being toot and robbed. You remain where you are. One of the keys that open heaven in the path of righteousness. The Bible says, "Righteousness exalts a nation, but sin is a reproach." When we talk about righteousness, meaning living right, doing things right, praying right, and living right. That is the meaning of righteousness. Your pastor will not say, "We are going this way, and you are going the other way." You are rebel in the eyes of the Lord. The Bible says rebellion is as a sin of witchcraft. When we say 4 o'clock, heaven agree. If you are coming after 5, you are a rebel. You rebel. Praise the Lord. You will soon get your going somewhere. If 3 years old baby, child, is not walking, the parents will be worried. Am I communicating? You have a 3 years old child, is not walking, still crying. Are you aware that the mother will have a lot of body and a lot of work to do? If you are a Christian, you are spent more than 3 years in church, you don't know your right from your left, you are spiritually disabled. Am I communicating? That everything that, listen to me, the purpose of you being a member, the pastor and reproduce himself in your life, you will go and reproduce yourself in others. That's the growth of the church. I told my member, you say, "Okay, if you're joining with us, you'll be blessed." It's good. What is attracting blessing days? Obedience. If you are a winner member, evening service. If the scene says 5 o'clock, 4 o'clock, already close your shop, you are running to church. By the time you obey God, why God will not bless you? Communion service on Wednesday, you are running. On Sunday, first service, they are starting by 7. Since the Lord, I didn't leave your house, you want to meet up with the boss. Why God will not bless you? But when we come to other church, you feel that, oh, let me go. According to my own convenience time, we say it's our year of showers of blessing. Some people will not even see you to talk about showers of blessing. It's not, let the man of God lay hand on you. No, the man of God may show you compassion and say, my daughter, I love you, you are blessed. But who will answer the prayer? God. God that answer the prayer sees your heart. Am I talking?
Yes, sir.
I'm here with one of my pastors. Years ago, I told you I'm going to be a pastor. He laughed. That thing was so deep in the world. I began to intercede on his behalf. I sent him to Bible school. We have a lot of pastors in our church today. And I placed every one of them on discipline. When we talk, what's the meaning of disciples? Discipline follower. How many of you are disciples to our bishop here? How many? We must deal with this old mindset. Oh, you are making the pastor. You are not minister back to him. You don't even care about his life, about his well-being, about the church will grow. All you need is our man of God. He will see vision for us. He will pray for us. He will deliver us. Are you aware that one thing that key anointing that upon all how anointed you are, you are not seeing the results in your church? Do you know there's an anointing killer? You organize a program, nobody show up, it diminishes your anointing. In our church, we have someone that's in charge of generator, in charge of toilets, in charge of gates. They must resume their duty posts. During our 12 days all night, your man of God will testify it. All the pastor, deacon, and deacons, you must be in church by 8. By 9, they start prayer. They will pray from 9 o'clock till 10. And as 10, now we start the main service till 10 o'clock every day. Your man of God have the word. He have the anointing. He have the grace. He have the evidence. If there is any wish that fight this ministry, we support that wish. How? Am I communicating? If, for example, the wish said you want to fight, as you were coming to church, you came with about 4 of your friends, including your children, that seat will cover up. As you are coming, you come with 3 people. What will happen to this seat? You will feed up. As you are coming, you come with your friend. What will happen? By the time the witch see that, upon all that I'm doing, people are still coming, he will believe that his power already failed. Am I talking to someone right now? The terrain our ministry are is a very strong terrain, but we are still making way. Praise the Lord. We are still making way. Why? I spent time to invest on my people, the world. The world. Now, let me run through it because of time. Open heaven over your life. Keys that open heaven. There's one thing today that Satan is attacking the church. Tithes. And those pastors you see on Facebook condemn tithes, they never have a church. They are Facebook pastor. Let them open a church and let's see how they will run it without tithes. And the word of God said in Malachi, the last book of the Old Testament, Malachi chapter 3. Follow me carefully, I'm taking it to somewhere. Verse 10. It says, bring ye all the tithe into the storehouse. I will not open you the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing. We are talking about showers of blessing. I'll pour you out a blessing. That there shall not be a room enough to receive it. Before God will open heaven, there is a part you must play. There is a part. I hope in this church during Christmas and New Year you remember your pastor. How many of you did Christmas and New Year for your pastor this 2019? Can I see your hand? Only one person. You, what do you buy for your man of God at Christmas Day? Did I listen? Eh? Money. How much? Okay, you try. God will bless you. What about you? Oh yeah. Bless you. What about you? Eh? Bless you. What about you, man? What about you, sir? What about you, man? What about you, man? If you say it's a husband, you are missing something. What about you, pastor? Didn't do anything. What do you do? What do you do? Why? Praise God. Although they were selling rice at 7,000, the rice I received was more than enough. I started giving it out. What? It's something that opened heaven. Praise the Lord. It's something that opened heaven. My father in the Lord, I bought him a ram. Big one. In this place of eternity, we see it. Why? I want to see another year that better than the year I'm living. Samuel, let me tell you something. Don't be so familiar to this man not to succeed. My wife will say that she's not working, but she don't lack. Sometimes she wake up and succeed for me. Succeed. I will say you are blessed. You see favor coming everywhere. Because the grace you acknowledge, it deals with any form of disgrace in your life. Am I communicating right now? You expect I will come and jump. This is not the time to jump. It's a man of God, we organize a teaching, training class. I will come. It can be 7 days. There's no month in our church we don't have worker seminar. By the time we are able to establish you, this ministry will grow. Growth of church is not by magic. Is by administration. Praise the Lord. It's by administration. Are you aware that when on Bible study, man of God, there's what we call the book of record. Any pastor that will come to church, you go and write your name aside. At the end of the month, if you default to the three times, you will be sanctioned. You may say, why? It was God that gave me the inspiration. Then we sang. Praise the Lord. Number one, the windows of heaven can be opened over your life, or they can be closed. How do I? Somebody should read for me. Isaiah chapter 1, verse 9 to 10. The windows of heaven can be opened over your life, or they can be closed. When somebody is operating under closed heaven, no matter what you lay your hand, you are just a joker. The notion is a joker. Is anybody there? Isaiah chapter 1, verse 9 to 10. Old Testament. Is anybody there? And we don't have anybody that can read here. So don't even have a bad Bible.
He said, you look for more and more.
You just might, sir. Yes, any mic there. Say, you look for much. At the end, he amount to lead you. When you brought it home,
I
did not bless it.
Why? Because of my house.
Because of what?
My house. Wait.
That is be abandoned.
And you hold every man to his own house.
Everybody, we are in a hurry now that want to go home. Yes.
Therefore, the heaven over you is made from you.
Do you see?
And the earth is made from our fruits.
From our fruits. You remember when Elijah spoke that heaven were closed for 3 years and 6 months, there was famine in the land. When you are operating under closed heaven, there will not be showers of blessing. There will be showers of blessing. When I look at the way some people have living, I began to wonder, when I'm in need, I sow. Anytime I'm in need, I will go and sow for my need. The same God that gives seed to the sower is the same God that gives bread to the eater. Listen to me. If you want to see marital fruitfulness, you need a key. So are you aware that no prayer will cure ignorance? The only cure to ignorance is knowledge. And your ignorance is the strength of your enemy. What you don't know? Somebody is living a foolish life. You say you want to pray for that person. No amount of prayer that will cure that foolishness away from that person. Only cure is knowledge. Somebody say knowledge.
Knowledge.
For example, you have someone, your children, they're in school, God forbid, your children, they don't know book. You say, I pray for you to know book, it will not work. Spend time to teach that your child or your son. Knowledge is power. Many Christians today, they have believed that they are witches in their family. As a result of that, they will not be rich. Who told you? Who born that witch? Who born that wizard? When a man will right with God, he makes his enemy to be at peace with him. Again, make it as zero, as envoy. Right in their presence and moving from glory to glory. They can't stop me. I have not their property in my possession. Am I communicating? Are we together?
Yes, sir.
Mother, sit where and look at me. Are you in church? Sit where. This is not how to sit in church. Sit where. Supposed to lead by example. Praise God. You are total you are now. See properly. You carry your Bible and your jotter. Look at me. Praise the Lord. We will come and cure some ignorance from you through the teaching in the name of Jesus. Number two, tithe is one of the ways to open the windows of heaven over your life. Is one of the way. I want to ask because this church is my church. How many of you pay tithe here? Only one. How many of you pay tithe here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Mother, you don't pay tithe? You don't pay tithe? You don't pay tithe? You are still learning. You don't pay tithe? You don't pay tithe? Praise the Lord. Do you see that? When you see thief that rob you, what will you do to that thief? Anybody that rob from you, you are able to cut that thief. What will you do to the thief? If God wants to really punish us, we are robbing from God. Can we stand the punishment? It's an error that you are a Christian, you don't pay tithes. It's a big error. Praise the Lord. You know, my friend is always easily discouraged. Anything you know that is in the Bible, even though it take you 2 years to inculcate into your member, do it! they are being blessed, they will come back to thank you. They will come back to say, thank you, sir, for helping me. Pastor Daniel is in River State, Cross River State now. When he was about to go, he came to my house. That was on Sunday evening, I've been Monday evening. After a discussion, he said, I want to say, Lord, free to go. And he placed just 2,000 on my feet. And I blessed him. That same evening, one of my relatives said that he needs somebody that will help her to plaster 4 flats. We said we have somebody. We connected them to that contract. That same day. You know what they call grace? A young man like that have 4 children. Twins are inside. He have car, he have wife. He's building church, he's building his own house. It's grace. Because any tree that the branch that break out of the vine, it withered. What you need in life is here. But you don't acknowledge it and you are not connected to him in any way. What you expect from what you are seeing today. I pray this word God says I should give you. And anyone that we are bound by it, this year you will not suffer. Amen. You know what it takes? I'm not working, my wife is not working. We have 2 car compound. We will eat, we take care of others, we take care of church. I told member, offering money cannot sustain me. But with that offering money, I sow it. I have more than enough to harvest. Praise the Lord. Our church pay tithes to another church. I pay my own tithes. I service my father in the Lord. Has said, he blessed me. I will never be lack. Never be lack in my life. Number 3. Open heaven means that blessing are pouring out on you. Deuteronomy chapter 8, verse 28, verse 8. Open heaven means that blessing have poured out on you. That is the showers of blessing. Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 8 said, I will command blessing upon you. This year, somebody will have a commanding blessing. Amen. Commanding blessing. Let us read that place, Deuteronomy 28, verse 8. Commanding blessing. Commanding blessing. Are you there? Deuteronomy 28, verse 8.
He said, the Lord shall command the blessing upon thee.
Upon you.
In thy storehouses.
In thy storehouses.
Lord, that thou settest thy hand.
Whatever you set your hand to do.
And he shall bless thee.
He will bless you.
In the land.
In the land. Do you know that this year is a land that the Lord has given to you? They say former occupants. Before you possess that land, you have to deal with the occupants of the land for you to possess it. Praise the Lord. I've seen some people complaining, my children abroad, they are not seeing money, they don't do that. Are you connected to the covenants? How many of them pay tithes? How many of them have a role they play in this church every month? But when they need, you run to pastor, man of God, my son, my daughter is in problem, don't say pray, we pray. But your son or your daughter are not into covenants. When you look at the book of Zechariah, chapter 9, verse 11, he said, As for thee also, by the blood of thy covenant, I have brought my prisoner out of the pits where there is no water. By covenant. If your son and your daughter are covenanted to this ministry, are you not don't see some church on television, it's not offering money that put that church on television. There are partnership. People that covenanted. So we say every month I will be giving this to the church. We have a covenant partner in our church. As I offer and tithe, people, the key to supporting the kingdom work. You will never connect your children to the ministry. But when it comes to prayer, you connect them. You will come and cry before the man of God. You will come and complain before the man of God. I asked a woman one day, "Madam, after complaining at all, I said, are you aware that blood flowing my body? Say yes. Are you aware that I eat? Say yes. Are you aware sometimes I can wear new clothes? Say yes. So you have been in this church. You are never in any way minister. If your pastor is afraid to tell you, he's robbing you. You are never in any way minister to me." The word of God said, as we minister spiritual things unto you, you minister to us what? Physical things. Oh, pastor, in my area where? And she started. Today, go and look at her life. The diabetes she was battling with for years disappeared with her prayer. Covenant. And when you also look at the book of Isaiah chapter 42, verse 6, he also talked about to open the eyes of the blind. Are you there? Isaiah 42, verse 7. If you are there, shout a loud amen. If time for me to stop, you let me know. He said, to open the blind eyes, to bring out the prisoner from the prison, and they that sit in darkness out of the prison house. The purpose of pastor is to open the eyes of the blind. Don't do it in a selfish way or in a carnal way. Showers of blessing, fruitfulness. How a man and woman that walk in ignorance have a chance of blessing and be fruitful? It will never work. There are some of us today, we go to church. Our offering on Sunday, sometimes 20 naira, 40 naira, 50 naira. And you also go and hold meeting on behalf of the pastor that the offering money will they see for this child and the user. And when you were unbeliever, you will go to market and buy goat of 17,000. You will buy yam, you will buy oil. You go and give to native daughter. In your presence, they will kill that goat and make pepper soup. They will tell you that you will never taste from it. You even talk and say, "Where's this, sir?" Because some of us, the only thing Satan is doing, know that when you come to church, you are covered. He wants you to be an enemy to the man God has sent over you. That is what the Bible simply means, that he that breaketh an edge, serpent will bite. Am I offending anybody?
Yes,
am I communicating?
Yes,
I want to see that this church expand and prosper. How are we going to expand? We must have the knowledge of the word of God. On Sunday, we hold a meeting. My pastor is here. We are discussing. I said I want to go and fence our prayer ground. A man stood up that he will give 40%. We never were talking about sand. He said he will do it. Man of God, you are welcome. Why? It's as a result of teaching and understanding. When you openly do the will of God, you must be blessed. You must be blessed. They have been laying on you, you have been falling and rising. You remain the same. Why? Because you are carnal. The knowledge of the word of God is not in you. The time is going to come. Prophecy will fail. All those talkative will fail. But the word of God will stand. You can see me. I'm not moving by people's success. I'm not being threatened by other people's progress. Because I know where I'm going. A pastor asked me that, you don't mingle with us, but you are making an impact. I laugh. When you talk to men too much, you will not hear from God. You will not hear from God. A year of showers of blessing. Even though you speak in tongues for 1 hour, if your mind is not right with God, there will not be due to talk about showers of blessing. You don't pay tithe. You don't support kingdom work. You don't even have any covenant with God. You don't encourage your pastor. God is not a magician. And God is not a 419. When you follow the principle of God, you must be blessed. I remember 2018, I made up my mind to buy a car for my wife. But the money I tried to gather was not enough. I sold it out. And the car came. That's how I live my life. That's how I live my life. I cannot boast of 20,000 in my account. But I can tell you that tomorrow I want to do a budget that worth 1 million. I will do it. I will do it. I will do why? Because I know the word of God said, my God will supply me all my needs. Before that prayer, read. He said, when we start this gospel, nobody communicate with us concerning giving and what? And receiving, except in Macedonia. And in Macedonia, they were talking about the people there, they were abject poverty, they were wretched, but they were willing to give. They were willing to give. When God called you, he was not a millionaire. We don't say billionaire, he was just another person. But he began to obey divine instruction. Today, now, he's blessed. When God called Adeboye, he was nobody. Today is blessed. Have you ever sit down to ask yourself, is it not the same Bible Adeboye study, Adeboye is using? Is it not the same Bible? Because they have the knowledge of the word of God, you are reading letters. God never said the letter key, but the spirit given life. Given life. Hallelujah. Then, number three. Okay, number four. The first blessing of tithing is to have devourer rebuke. It's to have what? Devourer rebuke. What is devourer? When we're talking about showers of blessing, your stand with God must rise. When we're talking about devourer, we are talking about unwarranted expenses. Hello, church. One day I came back from my wife said, only I want to buy land for my children. I said, where do you have the money? She said, don't worry. We prayed. He bought a land, shared for his four children. We don't physical cash, but we have God. Command says, whatsoever you desire, when you pray, when you believe, you will have it. There are many Christians today that run from church to church. They never have single faith. They are looking for magicians. Magicians, before they perform any magic for you, they make a demand. At the end, you are the loser. What a magician. Somebody will hold a kashi like this and turn it, they become a sweet. And turn it again, become another thing. And turn it again. It's just so, you want to manipulate your sense. By the time you are being carried away, it will be. Praise the Lord.
Yeah.
Praise Master Jesus.
Yeah.
It's not a sin if you are an evangelist. It's not a sin if you are an evangelist. It's not a sin if you are a pastor. If I may ask question further now, sir, how many souls have you won to this ministry? Your father is not so. We are by the delay in our relationship. All your family will follow you because you are the head. I'm talking about outsiders. You are one. No. But how many souls have you won? No. And the Bible said, go ye therefore and preach the gospel to what? To every creature. He that believe and baptize shall be saved. Listen to me. The Bible said, the fruit of the righteous is a tree of life. He that winneth a soul is wise. If you are not a soul winner, you are not wise in God's kingdom. You are not investing in the kingdom of God. People see our church today, they are a crowd of people. It's not a magic. It's not a magic. It's not a magic. Last September, the Lord spoke to me, changed the service time. Say what? I say 7 to 10 o'clock in the morning. So I go up and say we have it. And I announce it. For me, I don't, by the time I hear from God, I will not seek your consent. And I started. Today come. Before 7 o'clock, church already departs. Exactly 10, I will not say Holy Spirit is